stop. Well, stop spreading the news. Those were the Big Apple with Peterborough Middle School.
She passes each one she passes by.
Chesterfield School.
Thank you. Thank you. Soviet children coming over and us, and American children going over there. And they're in the midst of an extraordinary upheaval. And Mother Russia doesn't do anything easily. And intellectuals and artists are all excited about what's happening with Gorbachev's presenting the possibility of some freedom in their country. On the other hand, they're terrified of possible civil war and military dictatorship because there's a lot of people that don't want to change it. For a long time, they've learned how to work with the system, and they've got all their little quirks and their wonderful little systems set up. They don't want to change. And there's lots of frightening things going over there. Most of all is the KGB, which is more than just policemen or militiamen or anything, but it's a pervasive element in the entire society, and it itself is going through a transition. Some of them in the KGB are in support of Gorbachev, others aren't. So it's really fascinating to see what's going to happen. I only mention that because there's something that made my heart feel extraordinarily happy. When I saw the chief of police in Peterborough and our officers from Peterborough dancing in this show, and I thought, nowhere else in the world in America, nowhere could you get policemen to come in public and dance with children. It's extraordinary. There are fear and terror in other countries. In our America, in this area, it's extraordinary to see them. I love my children. It made my heart feel good. And backstage, if you were here earlier, you heard me yell at them. Officers, you're in the wrong set. Back up, stand, and your knees, smile. Anyway, they are enjoying. There are many people to thank. And it has been done by Kate. I just wanted to add my voice to Elle's parents, backstage, volunteers, friends that are helping out. Most of all, those little performers with their energy and their belief, their hard work, that are gracing the stage. They're our future. They're the future audiences that are going to be here. They're the future performers, perhaps. They're future patrons of the arts. They're going to have children. Someday, one of these boys will be sitting there, overweight, smoking a cigar, reading a newspaper, turning on the football on the TV. His little son's going to say, "Dad, I want to watch the dance." He's going to say, "You do? Good. I used to dance once."
Thank you. orphans. Seek shelter in the streets of migrants, but often self-centered city.
Thank you.
picture a familiar face from her past, but the name had changed. Why, that's a picture of Harvey Shapiro! Legs Diamond is Harvey Shapiro? I used to go to school with him. He had a crush on me.
Thank you. Oh.
here. There's a little theater I'd like to own.
Anything, dear.
But Mr. Fats has the deed to the theater.
Oh, I'll make him an offer he can't refuse.
The weekly profits of Mr. Fats' multinational, diversified cartel conglomerate, Global Growth, Inc., have outperformed the combined gross national products of the entire membership of the United Nations. In the inner sanctum of Global Growth, Inc., Mr. Fats presides over his daily business.
Oh! Give back the facts!